Hallelujah, 愿大家平安。
Hallelujah, peace to everyone.
今天下午我们要讨论一个题目，当人生没有答案时。
Our topic for this afternoon is where there is no, when life does not give you an answer.
我们每一个人都想要寻求答案。
We all wish to have an answer.
每一件事情的发生都想问为什么。
And everything that happened, we always ask why.
那无可否认，我们人生的经历多了，我们发觉我们生命当中所发生的事情是很难找到答案。
Undeniably, when we have lived long enough, we begin to realize that sometimes life just does not give you an answer.
因为不是那么容易就可以了解。
Because life is not an easy thing to understand.
最不容易了解一件事情，就是为什么好人总是会遇到坏事。
And one of the things that we don't fathom is why is it that good people always encounter trouble?
我们看约伯记第五章第七节。
Let's turn to the book of Job, chapter 5, verse 7.
约伯记五章的第七节。
Job, chapter 5, verse 7.
人生在世，必遇患难，如同火星飞腾。
7. Yet man is born to trouble as the sparks fly upward.
人生啊，充满了患难。
And life is just filled with trouble.
生老病死是必然的过程。
And the process of life is birth, death, illness.
但是中间还有很多事情。
And in between, there's still a lot of things that goes on.
有时候你发觉啊，那些做坏事的，或者是不敬畏神的人，活得好好的。
And sometimes you feel that villains seem to have a better life.
钱也比你多。
They have more money than you.
身体也比你健康。
They are healthier than you.
孩子呢，分分钟也是很正常，也是很健康。
And their children seems to be doing better than you.
哇，做什么事啊，都很顺利。
And everything they do seems to be smooth.
反正那些奉公守法的，或者是那些好人呢，都被欺负，都有不好的结局。
On the other hand, you look at the good people, people who are law-abiding citizens, they tend to meet with tragedies.
这种事情啊，自古已经。到今都有常常的发生。
And we have seen this throughout history.
当然，当你自己如果遇到这样的事情的时候，你就更难理解。
And yet, when these things come upon you, you find it even further, even harder to fathom.
尤其是如果你是一个很敬畏神的人。
Especially if you're a God-fearing person.
你读经、祷告、聚会、侍奉神。
You read the Bible, you study the Bible, you pray, you serve God.
你也不去犯罪。
You don't sin.
怎么你那么倒霉，常常会碰到一些很不好的事情？
Why are you just so unlucky to meet so many unfavorable things?
这个时候呢，心中有很多疑问。
So we have a lot of questions.
是不是我做错了什么？
Have I done something wrong?
或者是是不是神忘记我，不理我？
Or has God forgot about me?
当我们在读创世纪的时候，最后一个部分就是有关于约瑟的故事。
When we are reading the book of Genesis, the last portion is regarding this Joseph.
约瑟他的一生啊，也是充满了疑问。
And the entire life of Joseph is just full of question marks.
到他年纪比较大的时候，到后来才有一些答案。
And he only found his answer towards the end of his life.
但是他的一辈子人生啊，都有很多的想不通的问题。
And throughout his life, he has a lot of questions that he doesn't have an answer to.
他至少有四个很大的疑问。
He has four major questions.
第一个就是在他年轻的时候，为什么他告诉自己，我那么乖，却常常被别人讨厌？
And the first question he asked when he was young is that I was such a good person, why is everybody detesting me?
我们看创世纪三十七章。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter 37.
三十七章的第三节到第四节。
Genesis chapter 37, verse 3 and verse 4.
请读。
Verse 3. Now Israel loved Joseph more than all his children because he was the son of his old age, and he made him a tunic of many colors. 4. But when his brothers saw that their father loved him more than all his brothers, they hated him and could not speak peaceably to him.
这里记载啊，约瑟他是生在一个很大的家庭。
Joseph was born in a large family.
他爸爸很老的时候才生出他来。
And his father had him when he was quite old.
还有呢，约瑟的妈妈是雅各最爱的那个妻子。
And the mother of Joseph was the wife that Jacob loved the most.
所以又是最爱的妻子生了，又是很老的时候生了，当然就得宠了。
And he was spoiled by his father because he was born when his father was at an old age, and his mother was his favorite wife.
那就雅各就是以色列为他做了件彩衣。
So Jacob or Israel made him a tunic of many colors.
知道古代跟现在不一样，古代啊，那种化学品不没有什么天人工的化学品，要做彩色很困难。
And the olden days is different from modern days. In the olden days, there's no such thing as synthetic coloring. Therefore, it's very difficult to put colors on the clothing.
颜色很难拿到，要从大自然的提炼出来，非常的困难。
You have to extract colors from Mother Nature.
所以彩色的布料很贵。And
therefore, colorful fabrics are very expensive.
所以雅各所有孩子都没有彩衣。Therefore,
all of Joseph's children do not have tunics of multicolors.
但是就特别给这个雅各做了件，各个给约瑟做了件彩衣。However,
Jacob especially made Joseph a tunic of many colors.
这是摆明的偏心呢。It
is a very bold example of how he favored the son more than others.
我们知道啊，如果一个人孩子超过一哥的话。
We know that if a person has more than one child,
大部分家长都有超过一个的孩子。
Most parents today have more than one child.
嘴巴都说没偏心，但是心中是不是真的没偏心，自己才知道。
Verbally, they would say that they do not favor one over the other, but only they themselves know whether they favor one over the others.
当然也不能怪啊，因为有可能是你偏心那一个是最乖的。
And of course, you can't blame parents because the one that they favor may be the most obedient one.
最会读书的。
Or the one who's the smartest.
最听话的。
Or the one who's most obedient.
当然就得到父母比较多的关注。
And therefore, they will find favor with their parents.
但是父母偏心呢，也不要太明显。
But however, parents should not be too obvious in showing favoritism.
那个雅各的偏心就太明显。
And Jacob has been too obvious in showing favor to Joseph.
大家都没有才艺，就是约瑟有。
No, none of his sons had a tunic of multicolors except Joseph.
这种关爱，这种偏心，就让约瑟被兄弟恨。
And so this kind of favoritism caused Joseph to be hated by his brothers.
所以我们当父母呢，不要偏心。
So as parents, let us not show favoritism.
神造你儿女，不同的，有不同的才华，不同的特性。
God has blessed your children with different characters and different personalities.
那个不听话的，那个比较笨的，更需要你多关爱。
And the one who does not submit to you, or the one who is not as smart, needs your attention more.
现实生活当中，我也看到有一些家庭。
And in reality, I have seen some families.
他有一个，有两个，都被忽略了。
There is usually one or two children who are overlooked.
可能有一个弟弟。 有一个姐姐特别会读书，特别优秀，另外一个比不上就被忽略了。And
perhaps there's one son or one daughter who's especially smart, and the other is not.
这样都不好。And
the one who's not tend to be overlooked.
但是约瑟，this
is no good.
约瑟一听是问，为什么我会被人家讨厌？And
Joseph asks, why am I being hated?
我没做错啊。I
haven't done anything wrong.
还有呢，我们看第四节啊。Let's
read verse 4.
啊，这里说约瑟的哥哥没有跟他说和睦的话。
It says here that they could not speak peaceably to him.
还有，因为第二节，我们看第二节。
Let's read verse 2.
最后一句说，约瑟常常将他哥哥们的恶行报给他爸爸听。
And Joseph brought a bad report of his brothers to his father.
约瑟很单纯，你做的不对，我就要讲啊。
And Joseph was a simple boy. He saw his brothers did something wrong, he would report them to his father.
劝你不听，我当然要告诉爸爸。
If I tell you not to do it, but you won't listen to me, of course I will report you to father.
他搞不懂为什么我做对的事情总是被人家讨厌。
He couldn't understand why he's doing the right thing but being detested by his siblings.
第二个问题他搞不懂。
The second question.
为什么我要被出卖？
Second question he had is why am I being betrayed?
27节，我们看27节。
Let's read verse 27.
啊，上次提到27节。
Chapter 37, verse 27. Come and let us sell him to the Ishmaelites. And let not our hand be upon him, for he is our brother and our flesh. And his brothers listened.
28节.
28. Then Midianite traders passed by, so the brothers pulled Joseph up and lifted him out of the pit and sold him to the Ishmaelites for 20 shekels of silver, and they took Joseph to Egypt.
这里这一段是记载，可怜的约瑟啊，因为跑去要看一下哥哥，爸爸派他去看一下哥哥好不好啊。
So poor Joseph, here he was sent on a mission by his father to see how his brothers were doing.
他去关心哥哥们。He
actually went to care about his brothers.
这个去到那边反而被哥哥们下了毒手。
When he arrived, his brothers put him in harm.
差点要把他杀掉。
They almost killed him.
但是因为最后关头呢，他们就是决定把他卖掉算了。
But at the last minute, they decided instead of killing him, they would sell him.
这个就有点像说你好心去看一个人去看病啊，去他家里帮忙，结果在那边被人家被你要帮的人害你。
And it's likened to visiting somebody you think who is ill, and then on the other hand, they turn around and try to hurt you.
被讨厌就算了，这就是被出卖。
To be hated is enough, but to be betrayed, to be sold.
17岁的人最需要家庭的关爱，最需要父母的保护的时候。
A 17-year-old lad requires the love of a family more.
结果就孤孤单单的一个人就被卖到不晓得去哪里。
By his lonesome self, he was sold by his siblings.
你可以想象他被卖的那时候，心里面在想什么？
Can you imagine the thoughts that went through his mind when he was being sold?
为什么是我？
Why me?
我最乖，我最听神的话，现在我要被卖，离开这个家庭。
I am the most obedient. I listen to the words of God the most. Why am I being sold?
但是月色的霉运呢？我们说不幸，不在这里没有停止。
The misfortunes of Joseph did not stop here.
他一定问第三个问题：为什么我要被诬告下在监牢里面？
And why am I being accused wrongly and falsely and being put into prison?
我们看39章。
Let's read chapter 39.
19-20.
Chapter 39, verse 19. So it was when his master heard the words which his wife spoke to him, saying, "Your servant did to me after this manner," that his anger was aroused. 20. Then Joseph's master took him and put him into prison, a place where the king's prisoners were confined, and he was there in the prison.
早上我们讲过了，他被卖到埃及，在波提法的家里工作。
And this morning we mentioned that he was sold to the Egyptians to the household of Potiphar.
波提法的妻子引诱他犯罪。
And the wife of Potiphar tempted him to sin with her.
于是很不容易一个年轻人抵抗自己的欲望，抵抗这个祖母的引诱。
It is not easy for a young man to overcome his own desires and the temptation of a woman.
结果神得不到神的祝福啊。
However, he still did not receive God's blessing.
反而祖母一口咬定，反告他，还要侮辱他。
And his master's wife, on the other hand, accused him and put him in prison.
主人就相信那个他太太的话。The
master believed the words of his wife.
把他下到监牢里面。And
put Joseph into prison.
弟兄姐妹，我们今天听所谓的见证啊，都有一套的所谓的 formula 啊。And
today, when we listen to a testimony, there is usually a formula.
就是说，你遇到困难。When
you encounter a problem.
但是你要听神的话。You
have to listen to the words of God.
好了，你把神的话行出来。
And you practice the words of God.
那就看到得到神的开路了，保护了。And
you see God open up a path for you, and God protected you.
这个就是最后就荣耀就归给神嘛。And
finally, all glory be unto our Lord.
这个就是所谓的今天的我们常听的见证的这种方程式。And
so this is the formula that you usually hear of in our testimonies.
如果一个人有见证说，我为了听神的话，工作也丢了啊，孩子也死了啊，我自己也很惨啊，那这种见证拿出来，可能别人想听。
If there's a testimony today that tells you of someone who lost his job, his children died, and he is in a terrible state, I'm pretty sure nobody want to listen to that kind of testimony.
因为今天大家看的是一定要连得上，你做了一件好事，你就一定要好报。And
because today people always want to find something that they can connect to. That is, you do something good, you get rewarded.
你为神牺牲了某一些你的享受，或者是拒绝犯罪，你马上就得到祝福。
And for the sake of God, you have decided to deny yourself or to forsake some of your luxuries. You should be blessed by God.
意思是听了神的话，马上就被下到监牢里面。However,
Joseph, upon heeding the words of God, he was immediately put into prison.
你想想看，如果你自己是这样子的话，If
this were to happen to you,
你被下到监牢里面的第一天晚上，你有办法祷告下去吗？
Would you be able to pray on the first night in prison?
你还有办法相信下去吗？
Would you still be able to continue believing in God?
这是我第三次倒霉了。This
is the third time that I am being unfortunate.
我相信神，我要乖，结果我被恨。I
believe in God. I must be obedient, but I'm being hated by my siblings.
我相信神，拒绝诱惑。I
believe in God. I denied temptation.
再来，刚刚讲到我相信神，我被卖了。And
later. Earlier we mentioned we believe in God, but we're being betrayed.
我听我爸爸的话去关心哥哥，我被卖了。I
took the words of my father. I went to care for my brothers, and they sold me.
好，现在我听神的话，拒绝诱惑，我被下到监牢里面。Now
that I'm heeding the words of God, I rejected temptation, and I ended up in prison.
我实在够倒霉。I
am so unlucky.
很有可能我信的是不是真的
And I begin to doubt whether I'm believing in the true God.
如果一次这个神没有那么灵就算了，现在已经三次了。
If God didn't help me the first time, that's fine. But three times He didn't help me.
那我现在要开始我监牢的生活。Now
I'm going to begin my life in prison.
这些事情的发生会对一个人的内心的信仰信念有很大的打击。
These kind of things that happen to one person can indeed greatly impact negatively on the person's faith.
但是呢，他又同时间在监牢里面也继续的持守他的。
However, Joseph, on the other hand, continued to observe and kept the words of God in his heart when he was in prison.
这个就是最不简单的，对吧？That
is the most difficult thing that Joseph had done.
他还是选择做一个好人。He
chose to be a good person.
还是有机会，还是要帮别人。
He chose to help to be helpful to others.
甚至还帮别人解梦。
He even interpret dreams for others.
他帮人解梦，那个人都被放到帮助监牢了，自己还坐监牢。
And the person who he interpreted the dreams for was released from prison. However, Joseph was still in there.
其实他早就拜托了，我帮你解梦啊，那你改天出去的时候记得帮我一下，在法老面前讲几句好话，让我不用继续坐牢啊，不然我这个是无期徒刑啊。
In fact, Joseph had asked the person to please remember him when he's being released, so that he doesn't have to serve a life sentence in prison.
结果预设了要第四个为什么，他已经出现了。
However, Joseph asked the fourth question.
就是为什么我总被人家忘记？
Why am I always being forgotten?
我们看创世纪40章20节。Let
us turn to Genesis chapter 40, verse 20.
创世纪40章第20节。
Genesis chapter 40, verse 20. Now it came to pass on the third day, which was Pharaoh's birthday, and he made a feast for all his servants, and he lifted up the head of the chief butler and of the chief baker among his servants. And he restored the chief butler to his butlership, and he placed a cup in Pharaoh's hand. But he hanged the chief baker as Joseph had interpreted to them. Yet the chief butler did not remember Joseph, but forgot him.
约瑟帮了九正，在狱中解了梦。
So in the prison, and Joseph helped to interpret the dreams of the chief butler.
特别交代他,
he especially mentioned to him to please remember me.
好了，结果真的九正被放出来。Indeed,
the chief butler was released.
23节说，九正却不纪念约瑟。Verse
23 says the chief butler did not remember Joseph.
你可以想象，约瑟在梦，他知道有神的帮助，所以他才可以解梦嘛。
And Joseph knew that God was helping him. That is why he was able to interpret dreams.
九正被放出去了，他一定祷告，哎呀，感谢神了，这次有救了，这次我最后的机会来了。
And the chief butler, upon release, must have thanked the God, thank God that he had been saved.
神还是没有忘记我。
God did not forget me.
因为至少神我让我解了这个梦，还是有成全。
At least God has helped me to interpret the dream.
神终于要用这个九正来。 帮助我可以放出去。Oh,
Joseph would have said that at least God would have used this chief butler to help me release from prison.
如果你是约瑟，一定每天在那边迫切祷告，赶快，是不是有什么消息啊？
If you were Joseph, you would be praying every day to God, waiting for good news.
结果23节讲，他不记得约瑟了，一出去就完全忘记了。But
verse 23 tells us that the chief butler forgot about Joseph upon his release.
我想约瑟在这里感受到的不单只是人的忘记。
I'm sure that at this time or at this point, Joseph not only felt that he was forgotten by men,
他所感受到的更是一种神的忘记。
He even felt that he was forgotten by God.
有时候人倒霉起来，真的好像是不好的事情一直发生。
And sometimes when we are unlucky, we have a stream of unfortunate things happening to us.
到最后我们有个想法。
And at the end, we start to ponder.
然后神真的存在的话，大概他也不记得我了。If
God truly exists, maybe He did not remember me.
弟兄姐妹，有没有这样的感受呢？
Have you experienced this?
是不是觉得神忘记你啊？
Have you felt that God has forgotten you?
约瑟已经四个大问题，他没有答案。And
Joseph had four major questions, and he had no answer to them.
从他17岁到现在，快要30岁，20几岁。 十几年来，他一直都没有得到信仰上的对神的答案。
From the age of 17 till now, he was probably in his late 20s. He had never had found an answer to his questions.
为什么会这样？
Why?
如果你是他，你又会怎么样？
If you were Joseph, what would you do?
不管是我们是他的话，早就放弃了。
If we were Joseph, we would have probably given up a long time ago.
我那么坚守信仰，做什么？
Why do I maintain and hold on to my faith.
但是约瑟不是这样的人。
But that's not what Joseph is like.
他对神还是有存着一种信心。
He has absolute faith in God.
至少他没有放弃。
At least he did not give up.
其实他年轻的时候做了一个梦。
In fact, when he was young, he had a dream.
但是有一个重点。
There was a point.
我们看37章，创世纪37章。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter 37.
创世纪37章的第五节。
Verse 5. Now Joseph had a dream. He told it to his brothers, and they hated him even more.
第六节。6.
So he said to them, "Please hear this dream which I have dreamed."
第七节。7.
There we were binding sheaves in the field. Then, behold, my sheaf arose and also stood upright, and indeed your sheaves stood all around and bowed down to my sheaf.
其实约瑟在很年轻的时候做了一个梦。
So when Joseph was young, he had a dream.
他有一次在田里面，大家都在捆禾稼。
So in the field, he and his brothers were binding sheaves.
约瑟的禾稼站起来。
His sheaf arose and stood upright.
其他的兄弟的禾稼就对着他来跪拜。
And the sheaves of his brothers stood around his and bowed down.
哇，这个梦他当时不晓得是什么意思。
At that time, he couldn't understand the meaning of this dream.
应该是比较好的东西吧。
He thought that it must mean something good.
但是为什么神的话跟现实的差距那么大？
However, why is it that the word of God is so different from reality?
啊，为什么这些事情会发生？
Why did these things happen?
弟兄姐妹，有时候我们信仰最大的挑战是什么？
Brothers and sisters, what is the greatest challenge in our faith?
这是神的应许或者神的话跟现实生活当中有一些差距。
That is, the promise of God or the words of God is vastly different from reality.
神不是应许吗？ 听神的话的人要凡事顺利，生活长寿，身体健康。 为什么我会遇到这种事情？
Didn't God promise that those who heed his words, they will have a longer life, they will have a better life? Why do these things happen to me?
我们都会有很大的疑问。
We often have question marks.
约瑟就是遇到这些疑问。
And Joseph had these questions in his mind.
那有时候我们想想，为什么我们遇到这种事情？
Let us think about why these things happen to us.
你从当时的那个点来说啊，是没有答案的。
At that point in time, there is no answer.
17岁的约瑟找不到答案。
At the age of 17, Joseph didn't get an answer.
20岁的约瑟没有答案。
At the age of 20, Joseph didn't get an answer.
25岁的约瑟没有答案。
At the age of 25, Joseph still didn't get an answer.
甚至到29岁的约瑟还没有答案。
Even at the age of 29, Joseph did not get an answer.
得到什么时候有答案呢？
When did he find his answer?
等到约瑟30岁的时候。
When he was 30.
神一夜之间兴起他。
God rose him up overnight.
让他成为埃及的宰相。
So he became the prime minister over Egypt.
但是中间过程有十几年呢。
That process took over 10 years.
他不知道等过程当中有多辛苦。
He didn't realize how hard it is during the process.
但是神的话语在试验他。
But the words of God is trying him.
我们看诗篇105篇。
Let's turn to Psalms 105.
诗篇105篇。
Psalms 105.
第17节。
17.
105篇的17节。
Psalm 105:17. He sent a man before them, Joseph, who was sold as a slave.
18节。
18. They hurt his feet with fetters. He was laid in irons.
19节。
19. Until the time that his word came to pass, the word of God tested him.
这一章是回顾以色列人的历史。
Here, this chapter is reviewing the history of the Jews.
以色列的历史跟他们在埃及那段历史不可以分开。
The history of Israel cannot be separated from the time they were in Egypt.
因为在埃及那430年对以色列人来说非常的重要。
The 430 years the Israelites were in Egypt was very important to them.
那为什么他们会住在埃及430年呢？
Why were they in Egypt for 430 years?
因为约瑟先下去啊。
Because Joseph was there first.
为什么约瑟会先下去？
Why was Joseph there first?
他不是风风光光的下去的，他是被卖下去的。
He didn't go to Egypt in a grand manner. Rather, he was sold to Egypt.
从我们现在的角度，我们了解神的旨意。
At this point of time, we understand the will of God.
因为我们现在这角度好像是神的角度啊，你把历史已经跨几千年一次来看过了。
Because we are viewing this history from the point of view of God, we are seeing thousands of years at one shot.
已经发生了。
Things had already happened.
但是当时的约瑟看不清神的旨意。
But Joseph, during his time, he couldn't see the will of God.
更看不清楚以后以色列的发展跟救恩的发展。
He couldn't see what was going to happen after that.
他只知道自己很倒霉。
He only knew that he was an unlucky guy.
然后第十九节，神的话试验他。
Verse 19, the word of God tested him.
神的话怎么叫试验？
What does it mean?
有时候讲的话跟你体验的不太一样。
Sometimes what he said is different from how you feel.
像那个梦啊，好像很风光。
For example, the dream, it seems that Joseph was grand.
但是他现在坐在监牢里面。
However, at the time, later on, he was sitting in prison.
很多人这个时候都有疑问。
Many people began to question.
但是约瑟还是坚持他的信心。
Yet Joseph maintained his faith.
等到他30岁的时候。
Until the age of 30.
我们看创世纪40章。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter 40.
创世纪的第40章的46节。
Genesis chapter
41章的46节。
Genesis chapter 41 verse 46.
41章的46节。
Chapter 41 verse 46.
创世纪41章46节。
Genesis chapter 41 verse 46. Joseph was 30 years old when he stood before Pharaoh, king of Egypt, and Joseph went out from the presence of Pharaoh and went throughout all the land of Egypt.
这里说约瑟30岁做了法老的宰相，埃及的宰相。
At the age of 30, Joseph became the prime minister of Egypt.
一人之下，万人之上。
His authority is only that, is below that of the Pharaoh.
大家看到约瑟都要跪下去。
Everyone who saw Joseph must knelt before him.
代表法老。
Because he represents the Pharaoh.
在那七年的饥荒当中，大家要来食物，一定要求约瑟。
During the 7 years of famine, anyone who wants food must come and beg Joseph for food.
你不以为有钱他就卖给你啊？有钱他也可以不卖给你。
If you think that you have money, you will be able to buy food. That's not true. Even if you have money, Joseph may not sell you food.
所以约瑟在30岁碰到他哥哥的时候，就想起那个梦了。
So when he was 30 years old and he met his brothers again, he remembered his dream.
其实神没有骗我。
And God did not deceive him.
神也没有忘记我。
And God did not forget him.
其实原来神一直在按照他的计划来走，来运行。
In fact, God is still proceeding forward with his plan.
在他人生很后期的时候，才慢慢有一些答案，才了解。
And towards the later half of his life, he began to find the answer.
这里说约瑟是30岁的时候。
It says here Joseph was 30 years old.
啊，所以时间过得很长。
So time passed.
有时候我们以为说今天发生，今天事情做了，明天有一个结果才是见证，才是神的恩典。
We sometimes feel that if we do something today and we see the results tomorrow, then we will have a good testimony for the Lord.
那个好的影响，我要马上看得见，才是神的保护。
And if I see immediate good results, then it is God's protection.
有时候如果明天看不见那个果效，我就失去信心了。
And if I don't see the result tomorrow, I'm going to lose faith in God.
或者是我们用人的角度去看事情。
Or we view things from the point of view of a human.
譬如说，好人要活很久，就是神的恩典。
For example, it would be God's blessing if a good man lived a long age, a long life.
坏人最好明天就死掉，就是神的公义。
And it is the justice of God if the villains die tomorrow.
我们的思想都很狭窄，都很单，很简单。
Our thoughts are very, we are very narrow-minded and we are very simple.
但是圣经说，神的意念高过人的意念。
However, the Bible tells us that the will of God is above those of men.
我们看以赛亚书55章的第八节。
Let's turn to Isaiah 55.
55章的第八节。
Isaiah 55 verse 8.
第八节。
55 verse 8, for my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord.
第九节。
9, for as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts.
这里说神的意念非同人的意念。
It says here that the thoughts of God are not those of ours.
如果我们来写剧本，绝对不会像写预设这样的剧本，应该想说啊，平平安安都在家里，都很好，不会遇到坏事，好人就是有好报。
If we are the writer of Joseph's story, we would probably write that he is a good man, he has good rewards.
但是神的意念不一样。
But the thoughts of God are different.
那么乖的孩子。
A good child.
我要用他。
I'm going to use him.
为了要用他。
And in order for me to use him.
我要让他从小就受苦。
I want him to suffer at a young age.
被哥哥欺负。
To be bullied by his brothers.
被卖到，被出卖。
To be betrayed.
被人家诬告在监牢里面
to be put into prison because of false accusations.
我要锻炼他的信心，就算我不理他那十几年，他还是对我不放弃。
I want to test his faith, and I will ignore him for over 10 years.
这一切都为了三十岁之后，我要兴起他。
And all this is because I'm going to use him after he turned 30.
而我兴起他，就是要让雅各全族搬到埃及。
And I'm going to raise Joseph because I want the entire tribe of Jacob to move to Egypt.
在那边要住四百三十年。
There they shall dwell for 430 years.
为什么要在那边住四百多年？
Why dwell there for so long?
因为在那种环境，雅各一家可以从120个人发展到几百万人呢。
Because in that environment, from a family of 120, Joseph's family grew to millions.
你想想看，如果不是这样的话，游牧民族啊，他们继续在迦南地这样游走啊，也不会增长得多快。
And if you think about this, as nomads, if they were to wander around the land of Canaan as nomads, their population will not grow that fast.
所以神的意念高过人的意念。
So the thoughts of God are those are higher than those of men.
今天我们所遇到的所谓的暂时的不顺利。
And today, what we encounter, this temporary unfortunate things,
或者是突然间生病,
or our sudden illnesses,
或者是得到一些绝症,
or our terminal illness that we have,
甚至你听到一些不好的消息,
or the negative news that we hear,
譬如说有人得病了, 教会有人得癌症了,
for example, we hear of someone in the church getting cancer,
啊, 有人死掉了,
or someone died,
或者是我听到印尼教会有很多信徒得到新冠肺炎。
We have heard of many members in the Indonesian church contracting COVID-19.
甚至有很多信徒啊得到肺炎死掉的。
And we have heard of members who have contracted COVID-19 and died from it.
我们通常见证都是你得了肺炎，我们听了见证是这样嘛？得了肺炎啊，祷告啊，全教会禁食啊，他好起来了，这个做见证嘛，对不对
？And most of the testimonies we have heard is that members contracting the virus and they prayed. And they got well.
结果得病了，没有好好死掉了，哇！大家这么快就怀疑了。
However, when we hear of instances where members contracted the virus and died from it, we begin to doubt.
啊，怎么会这样
？Why did this happen？
什么神不医治他
？How come God did not heal them？
他是那么好的人呢，那么热心的信徒哎。
They're such wonderful people.
啊，怎么会这样就死掉了
？Why did they die just like that？
甚至有传道遇到火灾啊，不幸的离世。
We even have a preacher who encountered a fire and died in the fire.
你用人的意念去看所有的这件事情是没有答案的。
If you use the point of view of a human to view these things, you will not find an answer.
因为我们只看到今天。
Because we can only see today.
顶多我们从昨天连到今天。
The most we can do is connect yesterday to today.
我们看不到将来。
We can't see the future.
我们很狭窄，我们看到一个人好人活久一点就是好，就是恩典。
Our view is very narrow. If we see some good people living a long life, we think that is good.
他离世就是一件不好的事。
If they die, then it's something negative.
但是从神的角度去看，人的生跟死跟人跟死跟人看的是不一样。
However, from the point of view of God, a man's life or death is very different from a human's point of view.
其实，在某种程度来说，约瑟就是预表主耶稣。
In some circumstances, we can see that Joseph rather represents God.
Jesus. 约瑟三十岁做宰相，出来做宰相。
At the age of 30, Joseph became the prime minister.
主耶稣三十岁出来传道。
At the age of 30, Jesus began his ministry.
约瑟是爸爸雅各的爱子，给他产业。
And Joseph was the beloved son of Jacob. He was gifted a tunic of multicolors by his father.
主耶稣是天父真神独生的爱子，来到差来世界。
Our Lord Jesus Christ is the only Son of God, beloved Son of God. He was sent here by God.
约瑟是被父亲差去找他哥哥的时候遇到伤害的。
Joseph met his demise when he was sent by his father to visit his brothers.
主耶稣是被天父差来世界的时候，为了要救他的人而被伤害的。
Our Lord Jesus met his demise when he was sent by his heavenly Father to the world and died for the sake of the salvation.
但是至少约瑟没有被杀。
Well, at least Joseph was not killed.
但主耶稣被杀。
However, Jesus was killed.
主耶稣成为代罪的羔羊。
The Lord Jesus became the sacrificial lamb.
还死得很惨，被酷刑，被罗马兵钉在十字架上面折磨而死。
He died in the most cruel way to be crucified.
好了，以人的角度来说，这个很不幸。
From the point of view of a human, this is unfortunate.
所以很多门徒就失去了信心了。
And so many disciples lost their faith.
但是直到复活之后，门徒才了解为什么。
Only when Jesus resurrected did the disciples understand.
为什么主耶稣一定要受苦？
They understood why Jesus must suffer.
原来神的意思，受苦也可以荣耀神，死都可以荣耀神。
In fact, even death can glorify God.
没有错，健康的人可以荣耀神啊！神多帮助我，很健康。
It is true that a healthy person can glorify God. God has helped me to keep my health.
生病的人也可以荣耀神。
People who are ill can also glorify God.
我生病，我没有离开神，神还是帮助我。
I'm ill. I haven't departed from God. God still helped me.
生活着的时候可以荣耀神。
When you're alive, you can glorify God.
一个人死的时候都不放弃信仰，更荣耀神。
And when a person dies and did not give up his faith, he glorifies God even more.
所以我们不要只用人的角度去看一切的发生的事情。
So let us not view things from the point of view of a human.
因为你用人的角度去看，你永远没有答案。
Because if you view things from the point of view of a human, you will never find the answer.
预设了他后来再从神的角度去看以前发生的事。
Later on in his life, Joseph began to view his life from the point of view of God.
我们看四十五章，创世纪四十五章。
Let's turn to Genesis chapter 45.
创世纪四十五章的四到五节。
Genesis chapter 45, verse 4 and verse 5. Verse 4, and Joseph said to his brothers, "Please come near to me." So they came near. Then he said, "I am Joseph, your brother, whom you sold into Egypt." 5. But now, do not therefore be grieved or angry with yourselves because you sold me here, for God sent me before you to preserve life.
这段话是约瑟跟他哥哥相认的时候所讲的。
These are the words of Joseph to his brothers.
哇，这个时候哥哥很害怕。
At this point, his brothers were in fear.
啊，当初我们害的约瑟还没死。
The brother Joseph whom we sold, he's still alive.
你可以想象，如果你是他哥哥们，如果我是他哥哥们，我可能裤子都尿湿了。可能都没力站起来，没有力了。
If I were his brothers, I would probably wet my pants because I am in great fear.
就我们从小欺负的小弟。
This younger brother that we bullied.
给他卖掉的小弟。
This younger brother that we sold into slavery.
现在就是埃及的一人之下万人之上的这个宰相，我们跪在他面前求食物的人啊。
He is now the prime minister of Egypt, and we are kneeling before him to beg for food.
这次我们死定了。
So doom upon us.
这个约瑟这个时候说：“你们过来。”
But however, Joseph said to his brothers, "Come near to me."
我是你们的兄弟约瑟。
I am Joseph, your brother.
还特别讲了，不是从小跟你长大的那一个，是你们所卖的那一个。
And he didn't say, "I'm the one whom you grew up with." Rather, he said, "I'm the one whom you sold into Egypt."
他还记得是你们卖我的。
He still remembered he was sold by his brothers.
我们早上有讲，约瑟其实有选择。饶恕他的兄哥哥们。
This morning we mentioned that Joseph chose to forgive his brothers.
这是很不简单、很了不起的一个选择。
This is not an easy choice to make.
但是饶恕就代表忘记吗
？To forgive does it mean to forget?
有人说要 forgive 就要 forget 啊，要饶恕就要忘记。
Some people say that in order to forgive, you have to first forget.
其实饶恕并不代表忘记。
However, to forgive does not mean that you have to forget.
因为这个人伤害到你那么深，你永远不可能忘记。
Because this person has hurt you so much that you will never forget it.
其实约瑟很喜欢，很想忘记啊。
Joseph would love to forget.
他甚至有两个孩子，其中一个名字就是把他改名，就是忘记。他希望忘记以前的这些困苦啊。
His two sons, he even named one of his sons to forget so that he can forget his past troubles.
就好像你自己每天要告诉自己，我忘记那个伤害我的，我要忘记他，我要忘记他。结果你一想要我要忘记，你就想起那个人。
It's like unto you telling yourself every day that you have to forget the person who hurt you, but every time you say that, you keep remembering that person.
你不能忘记。
You will not be able to forget.
意思说是你们把我卖来的，我没有忘记这个事情。
And Joseph was telling his brothers, "You sold me to Egypt. I haven't forgotten that."
但是呢，第五节
，verse 5, he said,
不要因为把我卖到这里就自忧自恨了。
Do not therefore be grieved or angry because you sold me here.
是神差我在你们以先来的。
But God sent me before you to preserve life.
没有错，从人的眼角度是你们卖我。
Yes, it's true. From the point of view of a human, you sold me.
从人的角度来看，我该恨你，我该恨你一辈子。
So from the point of view of a human, I should hate you for the rest of my life.
但是呢，从神的角度来看
However, from the point of view of God,
是神差我来,
God sent me here.
所以这里连到我们怎么可以超越自己的怨恨。
So it here connects us to how we can overcome our hatred.
或者是对事情的失望。
Or how we can overcome our disappointment.
其实一切有神的安排。
Everything has the wonderful arrangement of God.
就算你对我那么差，你伤害我。
Even if you treated me so badly, you hurt me.
也是神容许的。
It's because God allowed it.
神可能要安排某一件更好的事情将要发生。
And God has probably arranged something more wonderful to happen.
我们看五十章，创世纪五十章，这是整个创世纪的结论了，差不多。Let's
turn to Genesis chapter 50, almost the conclusion of the entire book.
越是对整个事情，后来他有答案了。And
towards the end, Joseph found his answer.
二十，对五十章的二十节。
Chapter 50, verse 20.
十八节开始，十八节开始。
Chapter 50, let's start from verse 18. Then his brothers also went and fell down before his face, and they said, Behold, we are your servants.
19节。
19, Joseph said to them, Do not be afraid, for am I in the place of God?
20节。
20, but as for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good, in order to bring it about as it is this day to save many people alive.
这里又记载，约瑟跟他哥哥另外一次对话。
Here is another conversation between Joseph and his brothers.
为什么会对话呢?
Why would they have this conversation?
因为终于雅各就死掉了。Because
finally, Jacob died.
兄弟们很，哥哥们很害怕。
And his brothers were once again in fear.
哇，爸爸还在的时候，约瑟不敢杀我们。现在爸爸死了，可不能再报仇啊。
While our father was still alive, Joseph would not put us to harm. Now that he's dead, Joseph may want to kill us.
所以他们就去求约瑟，记得你已经答应过我们了，答应爸爸的话。
So they knelt down before Joseph and begged him to remember what he said to his what he promised to his to their father.
结果约瑟哭了，又哭了。
And Joseph wept here once again.
第十七节，约瑟哭了。17,
Joseph wept.
约瑟很喜欢哭。And
Joseph seems to like to weep.
在我们传统的说法，男人流血不流泪。And
traditionally, men would rather bleed than weep.
但是约瑟是一个大英雄，但是他却很爱哭。Joseph
was a hero, yet he seems to like to cry.
很多的感情在里面。He
is full of emotions.
为什么哭呢?
Why?
因为哥哥还误会他会报仇。
Because his brothers still misunderstood him, thinking that he would take his revenge.
哥哥到今天还不了解他。
Until this day, his brothers still do not understand him.
所以说他都再讲一次。
So he will repeat himself once again.
他都不要害怕了。
Do not be afraid.
我岂能代替神呢?
For am I in the place of God?
这句话很重要，有时候我们都忘记了。
This is a very important phrase, and we tend to forget about it.
有时候我们想要代替神呢。
How can we replace God?
你对我不好，我都要报应你。这我们要当神嘛？我们要当报仇，我们要当报应。
You put me in harm's way, and now I want my revenge. I seem to be taking the place of God.
原来约瑟在他从小受苦到现在，他都有一个观念，叫我不可以代替神。
In fact, Joseph at a young age until at that present age, that he always had one concept in his mind that he cannot replace God.
他对神有两个很重要的持守。
There's two concepts of God that he held on to.
第一个就是不敢得罪神。
One, he cannot sin against God.
在试探面前，他不敢得罪神。
Before temptation, he would not sin against God.
然后报仇的机会面前，他不敢代替神。
And before a revenge, he would not be in the place of God.
哇，所以二十节，从前你们的意思是要害我。
Therefore, verse 20 says, "You meant evil against me."
但神的意思原是好的。But
God meant it for good.
啊，这句话就是整个故事的结论。神的意思原是好的。So
this phrase, "God meant it for good," is the conclusion to this entire book.
弟兄姐妹，在我们的生命当中，有时候真的发生很多事情，我们真的没有答案。And
brothers and sisters, sometimes the things that happen in our life, we have no answer to.
对约瑟还好，他的苦很大，但是他30岁之后就。
And for Joseph, his troubles or the demise ended when he was 30 years old.
对我们来说，我们的生命还没结束，或者是我们的人生的结论还没有看到。But
for us, we are still living, so we haven't come to the end of our life, and we still haven't seen the day.
有时候我们看到一些好人遭遇一些坏的事情。When
we see good people encountering evil things,
真的没有答案。
There is no answer to this.
但是约瑟他这里告诉我们。
But Joseph here tells us,
神的意思原来是好的。
God meant it for good.
在人看来是不好的。
In the from the point of view of a human, this is terrible.
在神看来是好的。
However, in the view of God, this is good.
这句话在当时他讲不出来。
When he was suffering, he couldn't say these words.
在他被卖的时候，他不会说感谢主哦，我今天被卖。
When he was being sold to the Egyptians, he wasn't able to say, "Thank God, I'm being sold."
没有人做得出来的。
No one will be able to say these words.
在他被诬告的时候，他也不感谢主，我今天我被诬告。
When he was being falsely accused, he was not able to say, "Thank God, I'm being falsely accused."
感谢主，我被忘记。
Or thank God, I'm being forgotten.
感谢主，我坐了十几年的监牢。
Or thank God, I've been in prison for over 10 years.
当时一定是疑问。
And at that time, he was full of questions.
也许我们今天就经历一些没有答案的事情。
And today, perhaps we're still encountering things that we have no answer to.
但是我们有一个信念。
But you must hold on to one concept.
神不会做错事情。
God is never wrong.
我们看到的是一点而已。
We have only seen one point in time.
神看到的是整幅图画。
But God, however, sees the entire picture.
我们应该都有玩过拼图。
We have all played jigsaw puzzles.
你一块拼图拿在手上，一点意义都没有。那个长得很奇怪，又不晓得放哪里。
One piece of puzzle in your hand, you have no idea where to put it.
但是当所有的拼图拼在一起的时候。But
you have, when you have the entire puzzle put together.
有时当你把最后一块拼图放上去的时候。Or
when you put the last piece of the jigsaw puzzle.
这个整个图画就完整了。
The picture is now complete.
我们的生命遇到很多事情，或者我们身边的人遇到很多事情。
And in our life, we will face a lot of things, or we see people, or life in general will face a lot of things.
我们都不知道为什么。
And sometimes we don't know why.
但是我们要保守我们的信心。
But we have to maintain our faith in God.
第一，神不会做错。
One, God is never wrong.
第二，神安排原是好的。
And second, God's arrangement is meant for good.
我现在不知道为什么。
I don't know why at the present moment.
将来也许我知道。
In the future, I may have my answer.
就算今生不知道。
Even if I don't have the answer in present life.
在永恒的神面前，他已经有安排了。
However, before the eternal God, He has His arrangement.
最近我看了一个见证。
I've recently read a testimony.
在沙巴有一位传道。
In Sabah, there was a preacher.
他的家里突然间失火了。
His house caught fire.
差不多把家里所有大部分的家当、他的 belonging, 他的财产都烧掉了。And
his belonging was all burnt.
这个就是在这个传道出差的时候发生的事情。And
the fire happened when the preacher was away on business.
当然很快啊，左邻右里啊，弟兄姐妹啊帮忙救火。那后来就把这个消防员来之前，这把火就扑灭。
And his neighbors and brothers and sisters in the neighborhood came and helped him put out the fire. So the fire was put out before the fireman came.
这件事情非常不幸的事情。This
is a very unfortunate event.
我们不是听过一些见证吗？
Haven't we heard testimonies like this before?
还有火灾了。There
was a fire.
哇，这个火从这边烧过来了，对不对？
And the fire came and started spreading.
然后大家开始祷告啊，那个人就跪下来啊，然后长子也跪下来祷告，哎，个风就吹了，吹，把这个火又。 都吹走了，对不对？
So the person would be praying, or elders would be praying along with his member, and a wind blew and blew the fire into a different direction.
这个房子就没有烧掉吗？
And so the house was not burned down.
就变成一个很大的见证。那小时候我们都听过类似的这种见证。
This became a big testimony. We have all heard of similar testimonies.
但是这次传道的家里被烧掉。
But this time, a preacher's house was burnt down.
那大家一定很多的疑问。A
lot of people have questions.
为什么传道的家都被烧掉？
Why is it that the house of a preacher got burned down?
神不保护啊？
Why isn't God protecting?
但是这个传道自己站出来写了一篇见证。
The preacher himself wrote a testimony.
他的题目就是引用约伯记。
The title of his testimony came from the book of Job.
第二章。
Job chapter.
我们看约伯记第二章。
Two.
第十节。
Verse 10.
二章的第十节
，Chapter Two, Verse Ten。
约伯对他说：“你说话像愚昧的妇人一样。” 哎，难道我们从神手里得福也不受祸吗？
But he said to her, "You speak as one of the foolish women speaks. Shall we indeed accept good from God, and shall we not accept adversity?"
他的题目就是从神手里可以得福，难道这从神手中也不能受祸吗？
So his title of his testimony was, "Shall we accept it?"
神可以给你
God and not accept adversity?
神可以给你，神也可以拿走啊。
What God has given you, He can also take away.
如果神决定今天你要遇到这个事情，
If God decided that you're going to encounter this today,
我们也要接受。
We should accept it.
啊，就像当时约伯被考验了。
It's likened to Job, he was being tested.
他写了十几点，他还有他的一家，虽然遇到这个火灾，但是他们有十几点东西要感谢神的。
And he mentioned 10 points that he and his family must be thankful for, even though their house got burnt down.
哇，他说其中有一点。
One of the points.
他的妈妈通常在那个时候会在家里里面读圣经。
His mother, around the time of the fire, would usually be at home reading the Bible.
但是那天他妈妈不在。
But that particular day, his mother was not home.
火灾发生了，里面没有人。
When the fire happened, there was no one at home.
哇，这个就是一个值得感谢的地方。
This itself is to be thankful for.
房子是烧毁了。
The house may be burnt down.
但是人没有事。
But everyone was fine.
财产是不见了。
They have lost their possessions.
但是信心没有失去。
But they haven't lost their faith.
爱的见证，还有个见证。
He had a testimony.
还有家里很多东西都被烧毁，但是圣经章没事，没有被烧毁。
Almost everything in his house got burned down, but the Bibles were fine.
还有一笔钱呢，是他们代收，准备要拿去教会，交给教会当奉献的一个现金。
And there was some cash that was in the house that they have received from someone else to be offered to the church.
那一包属于教会的奉献钱，那个现金也没有被烧毁。
And that bag of cash that they were to be forwarded to the church had not been burnt.
他是注目在神的恩典上面。
So he was dwelling on the grace of God.
他不是说为什么我是个传道，反而我家里会遇火灾。
He didn't ask, "I'm a preacher. Why did my house burn down?"
他不去想那个问题。
He didn't think this way.
他说：“感谢神，你还保守我们全家。
”He said, "Thanks to God, He still preserved my entire family."
保守赞美诗没有烧掉，保守奉献没有烧掉。
He's thankful that his hymnals of praise was not burned down.
还有他感谢神。
Money was not burned down.
那个火没有烧到厨房，因为厨房里面有那个瓦斯气罐，如果烧到瓦斯气罐就爆炸了。
And he was thankful that the fire did not burn down his kitchen because there is a gas tank in the kitchen.
哇，那感谢神没有爆。
So thank God that the fire did not burn down the kitchen, otherwise the gas tank would explode.
这个房子的结构还存在，虽然大部分东西被烧毁了。
Even though majority of the house was burnt down, the structure of the house is still standing.
我就问候他说：“那你们现在住哪里？”
So I asked him, "Where are you staying?"
哇，我们住在教会，教会来救济我们，很多弟兄姐妹也帮助我们。
He said, "We're staying at the church. A lot of brothers and sisters are helping us."
哇，我就很感动。
And I was very moved.
我说你们的东西被烧掉，但是信心没有被烧掉。
I said to him, "Your possessions have been burnt, but your faith is still alive."
你的这个见证啊，启发很多在受苦当中的弟兄姐妹。
And I said to him that your testimony can inspire a lot of brothers and sisters who are suffering right now.
我们人生一定会遇到没有答案的事情。
In life, we will always encounter things that we have no answer to.
可能是你自己的问题。
Perhaps it's your own problem.
可能是你家人或者身边的人发生的事。
Or perhaps it could happen to your family members or to your friends.
最重要，我们不要对神失去信心。
The most important thing is that we must not lose our faith in God.
像约瑟一样，紧紧地抓住神。
To be like Joseph, to hold onto God.
到后来看回头。
And at the end, when you look back,
神的意思原是好的。
That God has meant it for good.
唱诗。
Let us sing hymn.
402首。
Hymn number 402.